Wasted all our money on lights. Still lighting. Never mind. Nice to see everybody here. Good to be back here in Pine Knob. And I know you've heard me say this before, but tonight we're gonna play some old shit. And we're gonna play some not quite so old shit too. And hello out there on the grass, everything all right out there? It's all good. We're going to carry on with a thing called Dodo.
Thank you. Broadway.
Thank you.
And now, in a stark contrast to that last piece, we would like to play you a song that is very special to us, and we hope special to you. This is a very, 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 very old song. And this song is in fact almost 10 years old this tour. So we thought, what a nice idea. Dust off the old 12-string guitars. Dust off the old storybooks. And bring to you, the people of Detroit, an old song with an old story, an old familiar flavor. And this song has got lots of loud bits and lots of quiet bits. Lots and lots of loud bits and lots of quiet bits. Loud bits, quiet bits. Loud bits, quiet bits. I think you know what I'm trying to say. And so, thumbing through my well-fingered dirty book here, I come to the story of two virgins. Romeo and Juliet. And so, are you sitting comfortably? Oh. Are you sitting comfortably? Yes. Well, I'm going to begin anyway. Romeo, over here, was 16 years old. And Romeo, like most 16-year-olds, was very partial to sexual stimulation. Juliet, this hand over here, was also 16 years old, and very, very large in the upper region of her body. And so the story begins. One day, Romeo telephoned Juliet and asked her out to a drive-in movie. Now, Juliet, herself today feeling like a little bit of sexual stimulation, decided to accept the kind invitation and said yes. Before long, Romeo whizzed round the block, then round the corner, then down by the dum-dum tree where the sailors sell contraceptives. And he was there at her house. Knocked on the door. Hello, Juliet, I've come to pick you up. Right, said Juliet. I'll go with you in your car to the drive-in. So before long, Romeo and Juliet were at the back of the drive-in and the movie started. And then Romeo, his hand nonchalantly, carefully, but very firmly, started to wander down Juliet's body. Until his hand engulfed her upper regions. Well, Romeo was getting quite turned on by this time, and he decided that now was the time for action. And so he ripped off Juliet's dress, and he very carefully, so as not to ladder them, removed Juliet's stockings. And finally, her brassiere, leaving her completely naked in the car. Onto an even more erotic page 3. Romeo quickly undid his trousers and he took them off. And poor old Romeo, he had to do this himself, you see, because Juliet, by this time, was in fact tied up to the steering wheel. Now, Romeo, who by this time was very, very highly aroused, approached Juliet, and she said from her, when she cried from her crouched position by the steering wheel, Romeo, Romeo, please don't come near me with that thing. I won't, I won't. And As I said before, Romeo was very, very highly aroused, and he said, Juliet, you cannot leave me like this. And Juliet again took one long look at that long thing and said, oh no, Romeo, Romeo, I mustn't, because you see, I just remembered that I think supper is ready. Yeah. Yeah. Walking across the city room, I turn the television on. Sitting beside you, I look into your eyes. As the sound of motor cars fades in the night time, I swear I saw your face change. It didn't seem quite right. And it's, hey, babe, we don't got enough to do. Hey, my babe, don't you know our love's true?
What's that tape doing?
With our eyes, the distance falls around our
bodies.
Went out to the garden, the moon seems very bright. Six simply shrouded men move across the road. So near the sun, across the
to the right,
hey, man, your summer's waiting for you. Oh, hey, my babe, don't you know I love
you?
Now I've been so far from you, far from your love. Oh, it's been a long, long time. Such a long, long time.
I got it, right?
Isn't it?
This is a good shit. Yes or no, man? Gotta make
Social security.
is Narcissus. It's time to
I know I've got Thank you.
must be, there must be some kind of misunderstanding. There must be some kind of misunderstanding. There must be some, there must be some, there must be some, there must be some misunderstanding. There must be some, there must be some, there must be some, there must be some misunderstanding. There must be some, there must be some, there must be some, there must be some.
Well, no one will know.
watching it. It's wetter.
What? I don't know. Poor beer.
Okay. Now, we're having some fun tonight, eh? And now, it gives me great pleasure, to introduce to you, populace of Detroit, two very glamorous, very well-read musicians, what we have playing on stage with us tonight. Would you welcome, please, from just down the road from Detroit, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Let's face it, M isn't that far from D in the alphabet. Would you welcome, please, on the guitar, the bass guitar, bass pedals, and not in his pyjamas, but in a nice green pair of trousers, a nice 42 number on his shirt with a green and white and a red number that matches quite nicely. On the guitar, Mr. Daryl Stammer! Yeah. Very nice, Dan. And also, from just down the road from Detroit, Los Angeles, California, would you welcome, please, the home of the best sports people in the world, and that includes the Lions and the Tigers. Yes, dressed to kill in a nice blue pair of shorts with white stripes down the side, a nice... What colour is your top, Chester, tonight?
Blue.
Nice green top to match his green and blue.
What?
Would you welcome anyway the tasteless dresser in short trousers on the drums, Chester Thompson? Yes, I must point out that in fact the blue ribbing around Chester's green singlet does in fact match his blue trousers. So I'm very sorry, Chester, I didn't mean to abuse you there. Very dress conscious. Would you welcome... Oh. Yes, oh yes. Enough of the clothes. Down to the music. This is another old tune. It's called In the Cage. I got sunshine in my stomach, like I just walked my baby to sea. I got sunshine in my stomach, but I can't keep me from keeping still.
Just Thank you.
Search everywhere just to hear who we all call. Walk up on stranger roads and this one in a world I used to know before. 'Cause I miss you more. Oh, and this song
Maybe like motion comes in first.
dum dee dum dee dum. When the sun beats down and I lay on my bench, and I wait in and talk. And there's always been a boy.
Yeah.
he's in it. Me, just a normal man. You can tell me, but now what?